know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
The colonial architecture of the city of Mumbai is celebrated across the world. Its grandeur and opulence accepted as being unsurpassed. But few realize that the city is home to a rich collection of Art Deco buildings. These buildings, built from the 1930s onwards, are the first expressions of modern architecture in the country. While it is acknowledged globally, few recognize it locally. But one organization is making a difference, the Art Deco Mumbai Trust, which is on a quest to document and spread awareness on the hidden Art Deco treasures of the city. We speak to Atul Kumar, the founder of the trust, who has spearheaded this mission.
Bombay has one of the largest collections of Art Deco buildings in the world, which is a fact that is not acknowledged anywhere, least of all by the people who live in this city and who have enjoyed it and celebrated it so much. And I said, we have this heritage which is hidden in plain sight and nobody is seeing it. So how do we put it out there and how do we create an awareness for it? And we are fortunate to live in a digital age and we can use mediums which are new and technologies which are new to create an outreach which has been quite unique. And we eased people into the awareness by presenting information in a very visual and appealing manner which drew people in, and that enabled a sensitization to the style which has now caught the imagination of many people within the city. Art Deco Mumbai Trust is a public not-for-profit charitable trust, and it has three or four tenets that it stands on. One is advocacy, the other is researching Art Deco, the third is creating a documentation inventory of every single Art Deco building within the city, and we're also creating a gallery of images which basically capture visually the entire landscape of Art Deco buildings within the city. And it's been a very enjoyable journey. The big focus of our research and our outreach and our documentation has been to photo document all the city's neighborhoods. So we have documented buildings from Chembur to Colaba, and we know that Miami has the largest number in the world, but today I'm proud to say that we have identified 633 buildings in Bombay, Greater Bombay Municipal City limits itself, as Art Deco. And we haven't even covered a fraction of the city. So it excites me to look at the future and the possibilities of where we're headed with this final count.
Sensitizing the next generation to the historic and aesthetic masterpieces in our midst is one of the key initiatives of the Art Deco Mumbai Trust. They work extensively with school and college students and expose them to the Art Deco jewels in Mumbai.
Our outreach initiative, apart from what we're doing through digital mediums, also involves engaging with school children. And we have now worked with almost 12 schools, and more than 600 children have come on walks or have had presentations. And likewise with colleges of architecture. We have also done a number of public lectures which have been extremely well received. We've explored tropical deco from Cuba to Miami to Bombay. We have hosted a wonderful series on single screen cinemas of India, repurposed and reimagined, as we know they're all under threat.
The city of Mumbai is ever expanding and its population constantly growing, putting its built heritage under threat of redevelopment. This has naturally also put the city's Art Deco gems under the threat of being lost. But the campaign around Art Deco is helping create awareness.
The future of Art Deco, and I wouldn't limit it to Art Deco, I would say every architectural style that's within the city. More so Art Deco, because there's a proliferation across the city. is under threat. And so there is an urban dynamic that is not unique to Bombay. Having said that, I think because of the outreach campaign that we've done and the advocacy we've done, there's been a multiplier effect. The maximum viewership of all our content is by people who are in the age group of 24 to 35. That's an audience that is really the future. And the fact that we've managed to engage them means we've created a bank of citizens who are now the first line of defense to protect this very heritage. And I think that will help the trust sustain its activities and also keep the city's architecture, the deco architecture, alive and intact.
These Art Deco gems, most of which are less than 100 years old, are unfortunately not recognized in the heritage legislation of the country, which has for long focused on the more monumental. However, a big acknowledgement came from UNESCO when the Victorian Gothic and Art Deco precinct of Mumbai was inscribed in the World Heritage List in 2018, driven by a citizens' initiative.
I'm always happy to recognize the way citizens of this city and the stakeholders are so deeply invested in the architecture and the heritage of this city. It's delightful that stakeholders were able to drive an inscription by UNESCO to convert two architectural styles spanning two centuries, 19th century Victorian Gothic and 20th century Art Deco, to be inscribed as a World Heritage Site in June 2018. That is a singular achievement. In fact, we don't know it, but we should be very proud of it, that the world over, the conversation is around how Bombay stakeholders converted their initiative and got the state and the central government to nominate a living, breathing part of the city comprising over 60 acres with 95 buildings into a World Heritage Site. It's a singular achievement. And I'm glad because I think it affords a unique layer of protection to some of the most iconic buildings in Bombay.
Any conversation about the Art Deco buildings of the city is incomplete without mentioning some of the most iconic ones. What's more interesting is that the deco buildings aren't limited to one usage or neighborhood.
Let me just go neighborhood wise and give you a couple of top picks. So starting on Marine Drive, I would pick a building called Saxaria building, which interestingly Mr. Saxaria was the cotton king of the world. He built his dream home on Marine Drive and it is still in immaculate condition. Third generation of the Saxaria family still lives there. Along the Oval Maidan, which as we know is part of the UNESCO World Heritage Site, which was inscribed 2 years ago now in 2018. I would pick Shiv Shanti Bhavan and I would pick Rajab Mahal, both outstanding buildings, architecturally intact. And a visual delight. You will not see that kind of architecture anywhere in the city. Moving to Fort, I would pick the New India Assurance Building, which has bas relief work by the Pansare, late Mr. Pansare, who have created life-size murals which reflected Indian modernity, mixed with the Art Deco style in stone-clad buildings, which were all the office buildings. If you move towards Bandra, you have homes and bungalows like Shenu's, right? Which is a beautiful one-story yellow and red building with the most gorgeous balconies and an easy curvilinear form that is friendly on the eye. And I would encourage you, walk your neighborhood. Bombay is full of deco. You don't have to come to South Bombay. You could be in Matunga, you could be in Dadar Parsi Colony, Shivaji Park, Chembur, Juhu, you name it, it's there. It's for you to go out there, look around, don't look down. Yeah, look down to watch out for the pavements, but do look up and look at those buildings and you will spot deco.
We couldn't have said it any better. We do hope that the city's Art Deco architecture gets preserved and the next generation also gets to experience it. The next time you're walking in the city, do look around. You never know which treasure you might spot.